Now I'm away back in England, and Ross is rather away back in England when he first went over there to stop at the Owens brothers. And this is the Owens brothers farm, and they've got a scramble course through their oak plantation. This is Ross getting some practice in the middle of winter. I think the Pommy boys had him on, I think, really. But he raced round here. They told him he wasn't going right. He wasn't going fast enough. That's Randy Owens looking at him there. It's a horrible winter's day. And a horrible little course. And you see Ross having quite a lot of fun going round here. Boys don't seem to do a great deal of regular work over there. I mean, they don't work every day at a job somewhere. They buy and sell the odd car, and the rest of the time they just ride motorbikes and go around scrambling. And Ross had 18 months over there and got a lot of experience with the Owen boys racing around England. This is in Herefordshire, by the way, about 50 miles from Birmingham in England. This is the Mr. Owen, who owns the farm, the father of the boys, and Ross's wife. And this is Randy Owens. And the photo of the boys actually doing some work. They're going to build themselves a car shed and a workshop. And this is the way they cut up their own oak trees that grow on the property. Ross in the light overalls, guiding the wood through, keeping his hand well away from that saw, by the way. Rolly Owen in blue, and Randy Owen, the top rider over there, is going to come around the front. That's him in red. He's coming out here to race Yamahas in the New Zealand Championship. This is Ross's first scramble. He got second in it, as it happened, but there he goes on the CZ that he borrowed. I see him again. They took photos of Ross more than anybody else, a bit like me, I suppose. But there he is in third place now. I think they lapped somebody sooner or later. A very similar kind, of course, to what our clubs use, really, except that it gets cut up more. I think they must use them more or something like that, but our courses don't seem to get so chewed up. Looks as if it's a typical winter's day over there, not a great deal of sunshine, because they don't get the sunshine that we do here. But let's see Ross again. He's passing somebody. That's him there with a white cap. Anyway, they tell me that he eventually finished up second in this first race over in England. Thank goodness it's not snowing, because he did have some meetings where it was snowing. It would be in late 1968, in our summer in 68, I would say. One of the circuits, I've forgotten the name of it, but this is what happens to the circuits in England. They get absolutely worn out. There's not a bit of grass left on this thing. They've been racing on this one circuit for years. It's a permanent circuit, And what a shame. It's dirty, bumpy, dusty, metally, or gravelly sort of a surface. The grass and soil disappeared off it long ago. These bikes must take a thrashing, pounding over this stuff. We'll have a look at the straight soon. The start-finish straight. It really is an eye-opener. And in green is Hickman, who raced out here with the International Motocross team about 1966 or 67. Pretty good rider on the Matisse machines. Let's have a look at this start-finish straight, will you? Look at that. Look at the waves that have developed in that thing over the years. Let's have another look at it. That's the start-finish straight. Our boys would say if they had too many circuits like this. It must be very, very hard on the machines, but boy, they sure get the crowds. Nice to see a bunch of people like that at your meetings, wouldn't it? I suppose they must have 30,000 people to this particular meeting. Looks like a pretty big circuit, a fairly long circuit, this one. But I haven't got shots all the way around. The cameraman just took the odd bits and pieces here and there. But it gives us a pretty good idea, but they sure get the crowd of people there. Any of the riders who are riding at this one, I'm sure Ross wasn't riding there, Randy Owens most likely was, but I didn't get any information. It was a silent film, and I've just put this commentary on it myself from the odd note which Ross sent out with the film when he posted it out to me. Well, it's getting towards the end of this particular reel. We'll just see a few minutes more of this particular track, and we'll say cheerio.